try to help one in the air, really lift it up in the air for us.
As you heard us, getting some people fit, you have to grip it to rip it.
See improvement already.
We founded the Adaptive Golf Academy in 2006 to train fellow golf professionals, other health professionals. This is home for me because I only grew up an hour away from this location. Just to be able to work with a stellar group of certified golf professionals, award-winning teachers, and then the therapists, from PTs, fully licensed physical therapists, to rec therapists, to physical therapist assistants and students that are learning how golf can play an important part in someone's therapy and recovery.
Gotta swing up on it.
This is our self-adaptation component of the day. We just came outside after learning everything through video and scenarios across the PowerPoint display.
Do we have anything flatter for him?
Really, it took a war to change the mindset. It took the Iraq-Afghanistan conflicts and our veterans returning home, and they gravitated to the game, right? So when they came home, they wanted to do something as American as they could. And really, the game of golf was waiting for them. So when you're thinking about the time clock, like a veteran that's coming out here that had a severe gripping need, not a traditional glove, not just a regular golf grip angled club would do the job. So our team of fabricators and designers, we're able to make this happen for him. And look, he's teeing it, and it's flying.
It's got a lock and load.
A lot of people say, hey, it's the growth of the game, but it's really a growth of empowering people. And it is the growth of awareness to make golf courses more accessible.
Well, nice. What happened?